Hey there, Ascension Pioneers. As I've said, there's going to be change in the weather and change in energy. And it's true, it started raining during this night from August 30th to 31st. And today is a full moon. And right about just in a few hours, I think in an hour and a two, there's a full moon. There's a blue moon waiting for all of us. And already I'm wishing all of you to enjoy it in your beautiful, unique way, to get from it the full benefits and to really merge with new aspects of yourself and also release the old ones. But I decided to really work. I was writing a lot, I was posting a lot today, and I wanted to get it all finished before lunch so then I could get time for meditation and to just be with myself for the moon. And I'm just gonna spend my day in bed right here in my room, which is where I'm recording again from today. And I really wanted to speak to all of you again about this cycle of the new that is really beginning. And the trust, the message of trust, because for the Ascension Pioneers, just recently this week, I have received two messages that are very basic and the most important, and they are the messages of beginnings and trust. Yesterday I was sitting on my meadow and I asked Spirit, I said, let me get the card that is most beneficial for us Ascension Pioneers towards the end of the year, you know, all these 4 months that are left, you know, until we really align with the galactic equator. And the message was trust. And the photo on the card, which I don't have right here with me right now, was the white mountain peak. And it's, you know, it's to trust that we have reached these mountain peaks that are needed to be reached so far, and to keep trusting, you know, because sometimes not all things right now, right here, are already as how we would desire them or how we perceive life is to be. You know, what is the best version of our lives for ourselves? Because we have this personality imprint of that, our personality's aspects, you know, that do have these desires and aspire towards certain goals that maybe are not goals of our soul. And we are still learning to recognize and discern between the two. And I have a feeling that this full moon, because it's so powerful, it happens twice in a month. You know, we have blue moon is the moon that happens twice in a month, and this was right now in August. And I have a feeling that this moon is so intense because it's actually bringing all aspects of what we have been working with, you know, what we have been striving for this entire time ever since the beginning of 2012. And that is why yesterday did the Ascension overview and update on some new things and issues. So the thing is, I have a feeling that there's this great completion of a cycle, and I continue to speak about this because whenever I tune into YouTube or somewhere else, everyone else speaks about the same things. Oh yeah, and I'm having my pajama day as well, so don't get too scared if you see kitties, little kitties, little kittens. So anyway, the thing is, it's like this full moon represents an aspect where all these challenges and all these lessons that we've been learning and experiencing for the greater good, because you have to remember our soul will always choose and pre-plan the challenges and experiences that we need to embody certain aspects that we will later pass on to others. We will role model them to others. That's why we are teachers through embodiment right now in this age of Aquarius. So we cannot compare ourselves to anyone. We are each experiencing things on our own level and different experiences because we are doing this through the journey of our soul. So all these challenges that we were facing with and we were experiencing are now like building up, and it's like we're relieving each and every one of them. It's like we're concluding this cycle. And the conclusion of the cycle is also represented through certain shifts in astrology, and I've been posting about this today. Please do read and check out the text below because there's a beautiful description of what is going on energetically right now. As above, so below, in the heavens and here on our planetary level, what we're walking through and which challenges and what we are assimilating. Because on each conclusion of a cycle, what we do is we take a look, we do an overview, we see what we've been learning, what we've been experiencing. We take only the experiences, we take only what really is needed for the service onward, and we say goodbye to everything that no longer serves us. And we say goodbye to the stories and situations and to our thought processes that are more associated with their beliefs, you know, these are attachments, and we need to let go of how certain situations, people, and how we are come to abundance, how we are come to a perfect relationship, what this is supposed to look like. We need to let go of this in order for the real divine story to unfold. So on each conclusion of the cycle, we're dealing with that. So that is why I ask each and every one of you, are you ready? You know, because when a cycle concludes, you know, there's this new opening, and it's like you're traveling in a road. We're each traveling this road through our own soul journey, because you have to know, it's like the metaphor here is same goal, same destination, all leading towards the one, but we each have a different journey, a different road that we will choose. But on every road, you know, there might be also some bumps in between. The road is not always a smooth one. So you need to be prepared, and that's why there were these challenges and they continue. But I was really happy because when I watched yesterday's video from this older man who makes awesome astrology videos, which I really like, he always gets things to the bottom and he always really nails it. And he said that September really is going to move the energy forwards again, because we were like contemplating a lot, doing things, experiencing things, contemplating how to really embrace the new, how to implement new things. And the whole year, if you have been following certain teachers and role models, what they've been saying, or certain astrologers, everyone was saying basically the same thing. We were really tapping into the zone of unknown, and now we're more facing with how to really change things, how to shift things now. You know, that's why I say it's like a cycle of change begins. Are you ready? The cycle is really beginning. And he says that the astrology of the month of September will also pave the way for November and October as well. And I feel that he says there's some major decisions that will be made, not just on our personal level, also globally. And this is so true. I mean, for me, you know, a lot of new ideas are now anchoring through me again, and I will need to implement them, ground them in the physicality, you know, make some new physical moves, you know, that sometimes are not pleasant and you need to deal with a lot of work. Be careful not to go into stress and thinking, oh, I need to do so many things to get this done. You have to look at it as through steps. You know, each day you do something that you're guided towards. Don't do anything by force, because when you're doing it by force, there's no flow. Either something goes wrong or it's very, you're trying to push. Don't push. When your day flows, you will know you're divinely guided. When it doesn't, you know, when you know you're just not doing what your soul is offering to you. It can be much smoother. It can be much more gentle and graceful. It can be much more of soul, not just as to how personality wants. For me, I remember towards the end of the spring, I really imagined my summer to be a certain way, and then it ended up a whole different story. And if I would remain attached to that outcome that I imagined in my head, I would really suffer. I would create bad experiencing within me. I would get emotional. I would prevent this flow. I would prevent trusting in the creation that, you know, there's divine order in all things, and all natural things is the development, because creation continues to shift. And whether or not we get to decide the old or the new, it shifts anyway. So remember that it will always keep shifting. And if you're not ready to shift with it, you know, you will just go to another level of it, to another level of experience. This is what is happening now, and I have the feeling that there's this great conclusion happening right now. So it's really important to stay grounded and stay with yourself, with your own energy for the time of this full moon, which is not just today or the hour, the exact hour of this full moon, which is, you know, for some people, it's literally happening when they are already beginning the month of September. You know, it depends on where you are in the world, but this is how it is. And it marks this crucial passage. Like, we're passing through something. It's hard to describe, because some things we don't know so much as how we used to feel it, because we are learning how to stay in the zone of not basically knowing, just trusting and going with our flow, which is our heart. And heart living means not knowing, residing in that space, whether you don't know whether you'll get that money support tomorrow. You know, you will base your decisions whether you will be more secure or not. You're not able to do that through heart flow. You just got to make the decision anyway. There's no more, you know, that safety zone or someone giving you that comfort space. You have to decide first, and then the change comes. This is what is happening in the new. So while we're doing these interchanges, we're doing them on a planetary galactic conscious level as well. and much broader and much wider. And what is also happening that is very cool for me is when I tune again and onto the internet and YouTube, and after a while I was really giving myself to, you know, my time, really going at it at the videos and really filling myself up with the data, what is going on in the world and what people are talking about. It's all the same, because so many now, I've seen many videos on this topic the same way. Everyone talks about a certain breakthrough that is supposed to happen from September on, that basically the power that was given to the elite, to others, you know, to those who are powers that thought they were to be, you know, they were serving a certain purpose. But it feels like now they say, a lot of people say the shift, you know, the tipping of the scales is already pointing towards the direction of our empowerment. So that a lot of the people, the majority of the people, will really refuse an old way and old ways of thinking and being. So there will be enough people to tip the scales. The mass of the people should be enough. And then I watch something else and they say the reigns of the dark, they're like ending. They no longer serve a purpose, because once you learn something, it no longer serves you. And that's why I feel this cycle is ending in a way. None of us knows as to how exactly change is going to come, but so many of us feel it. And this is the heart knowing. You feel something, it's above your five senses. It's even above your psychic abilities. Well, some people call this psychic abilities. It's not coming from the heart. Psychic abilities are usually vision, sight, or hearing, or mental images. But this has nothing to do with psychic abilities. This is just feeling of the heart in the now moment. And every day it is changing, but some things you feel that are more in the general scheme of things, you feel them more. It's like this inner knowing that you can't really describe, but when you see other people talking about it as well, you say, oh my God, I'm not alone in this. Such a synchronicity, see? And that's when you get this confirmation, and you see that so many others are speaking about this as well, so it cannot be random coincidence. You know, there's still those who think we're just making things up, and it's fine, and it's okay under a level of awareness. But we feel things now. When we feel these cycles that are coming to a conclusion, it's like this preparation before the end of the year. But it's not just about the end of the year, it's about something much grander, much bigger, and it's about us fully remembering the self and fully remembering our mission. That is very physical. A lot of us have been awakening and feeling our mission, like glimpses of it and knowing what we are to do, but they were just glimpses. But now we're kind of coming into this stage when certain cycles have ended, when we're doing so much clearing and we're still doing it, because everything that is this old junk needs to fall away, literally, because you cannot enter the purified state whether that is not purified. So basically it's about this shifting and us remembering, and us really remembering and start doing that mission. It's not just about remembering why you're here, whether you're a light worker, you're a server to this planet, you belong to this greatness, and you've came here and you were involved with the planet ever since the beginning of creation with it, which is what many people, including myself, feel. And you're here to really, you come at a certain stage of the planet, of the planet's evolution and development, when you kind of help to uplift it to another stage. This is what I feel for myself. I've been coming as a soul, as a part of this greater consciousness, to do this in this transitional periods, in this periods of the great transition. But this right now is not so much important. It's not so much right now as to people, you know, who like to ask themselves, what was I in a previous life? Why am I here? And discussing spirituality from A to Z. But it's about you fully not even caring about that, but really being grounded here and now in your physicality, in your body, like 100% and more, if that is possible, in your vehicle, present, here, now, and doing that earthly vision, earthly version of your spiritual mission, because you're doing it here on Earth. Those who have not come to stay here and do the mission here are residing in the realms above. There is no such thing as below, above, but you know what I mean. In other realms, other dimensions. So the thing is, right now, it's really more important to anchor everything that we have learned. Take the experience, take the vibrations that you have achieved and remember through it, and then move forward, transcend it, you know, like when things transpire that no longer feel that they are needed, they just transpire. The more that you would hold on to them, the less it serves you. So it's kind of time to let those, you know, knuckles loosen up and just relax and let go. But also not just believe that there's this, people like to have this illusion that, oh, it's all it's supposed to be, so I'm going to be passive now. It's again, it's a middle path. It's about believing and knowing and feeling that everything is directed through this divine order and divine will, but then also participating in it, you know, consciously co-creating with it, taking control, but not controlling things. You know, it's like you're helping to hold on to the boat that is just flowing, just so you don't fall off. So just that the boat is in flow, but you don't take control over the vehicle and say, oh, I'm going to drive it alone. And there is no greater force behind this. So it is about trusting this greater force, because we're all part of it, we're co-creating with it, but it's also about helping to navigate with it, co-creating with it, because we're becoming creator gods, literally, on this planet, not literally creating worlds and realms, but on this level, we're remembering that we are the ones who get to create this reality as we would like it to. So really, honestly, the cycles are ending, new ones are beginning, and every transitional phase is not easy. It comes with, I said, bumpier roads. But remember, when you see a challenge, you are already wise enough to know, hey, what's there? There's something lies there for me and for others, because I get to serve through that. So stay in your space, stay in your circle, and keep reminding yourselves that there's this bigger picture that's also happening, you know, behind the veils of just your personality, having this idea of what is really going on. There's always this greater, grander, you know, scheme of things. So I think I also wanted to mention something about, I don't know. I really don't know, because I just speak from the whatever flow it comes through to me. But I wanted to mention something about this trust, the oracle card that I received, because trust is what keeps us here. A lot of us have had these preconceived ideas as to what is supposed to happen and what is a perfect partner, how does a perfect relationship look like, and when still something is not totally like this, you know, you might get to have this fear consciousness stir up inside you again, and you might get to feel, oh, so then this is not a right partner for me because things are not like this and like this and like that as to how I felt them. It's not always a feeling. Sometimes it's just like this world is a certain way, and we have these visions that are not always coming from the soul. They're so-called expectations and what we have been pre-taught, or, you know, the patterns that we collect from the collective. So sometimes it's really basic for you to ask yourself, is that pattern coming from me? Is it coming from the soul? Is it coming from the outer external reality that influences my mind thought patterns? This is really important right now, because this journey needs to be about you and you only. And that means you as a soul embodied in this body. You know, you no longer get to give your power away to these thought patterns and beliefs of the, you know, the collective, because the collective is basically being reconstructed while we really connect to ourselves. So the more that we tune out of that collective, we are actually tuning in with a new vibration, a new frequency, in a new improved way. So what happening now, you know, even with the moon node switching, you know, it's like the south, I think, represents the old, the older version of ourselves. Like, I was really watching about this. I'll try to explain. And the north node, it presents the more futuristic version of us, the new. And the old is, you know, the new is like a path of a soul, of our soul here on earth right now, this lifetime. And the old might even represent for some people past lives, or should I say other things, other fractions of that multidimensional state that you are. So it is right now really important to not to stay in that comfort zone of what was known or what was experienced before, because we have taken upon a different life path now, and we have a certain mission, and we're all striving to have that mission, you know, fulfilled with success, because this is what we're here for. And that's why it's important to keep that balance between the old and the new, because the old can actually be the new, you know, in the sense that you do get to recreate things that are, everything is of an eternal space when you think of it as such. So therefore, in this perception, there is no old and new. It's just you get to recreate and re-experience things, but in a new manner. So that's why there's this great balance that is needed. Every time you pick something, you learn about, but don't stay there, because you keep learning and you continue to learn. And the more that you stay there in a certain knowing, you will be left behind. You will be stuck in that zone. So we have to keep pushing forward because we started evolving, and once you push the trigger, the button for the evolution, it cannot be stopped. It's a natural thing, you know, it happens, like a creation of the planet, like a creation of a certain species. So we are basically recreating ourselves again, and our lives are being recreated again, and we're taking our power back, and certain things on this planet are going to change, maybe even rapidly like this in an instant that we might have thought and felt, but when it comes, it's no longer expected in that short frame, because there might be some things that might shift really fast, some people say. But who knows, and let us allow to be always surprised, always live in that space of, you know what, whatever happens is supposed to happen anyway, because that is the truth that is behind every other partial truth, is it's all as it's supposed to be, always, forever, and eternally. So, beloved Ascension Pioneers, keep walking this path, enjoy your beautiful full moon day and weekend, because like I said, it's not just about this day. The energies are always around this day, a few days after or prior, we are in this field, and the energies are also always, it's not just about the moon or the sun or the other planets, they're about our vortex space that is us. It's about us, it's about our inner power. So keep thinking about that. Just ask yourself, what is this external bringing and activating within you? For instance, I have to give this example. It's just like something I was feeling yesterday. I was lying on my meadow. I was just lying there. I fell asleep for a bit. Then I wake up again. I look at the sky. I was looking at the sun and then the clouds. And they were doing the chemical weather again. You know, there were chemical clouds, chem clouds. And there were a lot of chemtrails and the energy. I just felt it as to how it was decreasing. And I was getting more and more anxious, just feeling not so beautiful as it did the entire week, you know, because when the energies are intensified on the planet, which are divine energies, you usually feel uplifted. And for me, I get a lot of spiritual insights. And when there are energies that are more external in nature that are done through the manipulation of the surroundings, then it's a different feeling, it's a different vibration, it's a different resonance. You feel more heavy, you feel more emotional. Before you felt like more divine, it's like everything was fine and you were just in your flow. But then this comes. And I was observing myself very consciously as to how this influenced my inner reality. But then I got to this point, you know, after saying, oh my God, they're doing this again, you know, why did it make me feel that way? But then I went from this disempowered state and I asked myself this question, you know what? What if, because everything serves a purpose, what if what they're doing, they're actually serving humanity, because they're triggering that emotional state, that reactive state, which needs to come out. So basically they're serving humanity through that, because, you know, you get the activation of the highly energized, potent energies. I know that doesn't make sense, but you know what I mean. Divine energies. And then this comes. But it has to, because on a new level, you have to open up a new level of that emotional states and that which was hidden from you before. So basically, they are serving humanity through that, because they give you an opportunity to awake faster, because you get to, you know, when you're in that wounded state, you question yourself more. You're more emotional, and that causes for you to question yourself more. So questioning always leads to awakening, you know, you see? So that's how you really recognize when you're coming from that more highly enlightened state, not just that victim mode. You see that everything truly serves a purpose and it's all beautiful. And for me, when that triggers, whether it's something about relationships, I just feel now there's instant need to address this. For instance, in relationship, you have to talk about it that instant, that moment. Because the moment you let it go, now with energies are so intense, we have to deal with it fast, because otherwise it just clutters up even more. And it blocks your flow. So it needs to be addressed very suddenly, whether you talk it over with someone or really do the clearing, conscious clearing on yourself, whether it's just something that you're feeling inside of you. But just address it right away when the challenge appears, when the feelings reemerge, okay? So that's my message for all of you today. A new cycle is beginning. No one can stop it. The button was pushed, you know, some say, and I feel this was predetermined long, long time ago, even before the creation of the planet, because like I read it in my last automatic writing, it was pre-plan how a certain grouping of souls are about to experience reality and matter in this realm and on this planet. So all is good. just is. All just is. Take care, my beautiful pioneers, and I'll talk to you soon. Much love. Bye.